In this video, we are going to talk about how to install Python 3.10.6 in Windows step-by-step. So please stay tuned. First of all, you should go to python.org, which I will put the link in the description below. And then you should click on this, Downloads. So I click on this. And now we can see a page like this will be open. So scroll down. Now here you can find Python 3.10.6. So you should click on it. And then a page like this will be opened. Now you should scroll down until you see these files. And for example, I have a 64-bit Windows, so I'm going to use this link. But if you have a 32-bit Windows, you can use this link. But because I have a 64-bit Windows, I should click on this link. And now suppose that I want to download the file in my H drive and in a folder called Python, and also in another folder, which is inside this folder, which is called Python 3.10.6. So I press save and I start the download process. And after finishing the download process, I should open the containing folder. Now I should right click on the installation file and I should click run as administrator. Then in this window, remember to check add Python 3.10 to path. This is a very important step. And now I want to customize the installation process. So I should click on this and here I press next. And I want to change the install location, so I simply delete this location. And for example, suppose that I want to install Python in this folder. And remember that this location is very important and we need it by the end of the video, so don't forget to copy this location because it's very important and we need it by the end of the video. Then I simply click the install button and I should wait for the installation process. And as you can see, it says setup was successful. So I close this window. And now if I open the startup windows, you can see here we have IDLE Python 3.10. And also we can search that. So you can see IDLE. So you can see I have different IDLE, but this is the thing that we have just installed, IDLE Python 3.10. So I click on it. And here is the IDLE, which I can start coding. So let's maximize it. And this IDLE provides you different places for coding. And one of those places is this shell environment, which you can start coding. So for example, suppose that I want to print 5 times 9. And if I press enter, you can see 5 times 9 is equal to 45. So this is one place which is called shell. And also there is another better place for coding. In order to do so, you should click on file, then new file. Then here you can start coding. So suppose that I want to print something. So let's say I want to print hi. And after that, I want to print, for example, 5 times 8. And that's it. And now suppose that I want to save this file. So I should click on file. Then I should click on the save. Then I should choose a location for saving my files. So you can see I've chosen H drive, YouTube folder, and also another folder, which is called Python. So, and I want to name it, for example, code 01. And if I press save, and as you can see, if I go to this folder, you can see here is my code. And also I can run my code as well. I can click on run and run module. So you can see here is the output. It says hi, and this is the result of 8 times 5, which is the output of these lines. And also remember that you can check the version of Python in order to verify that you have installed Python 3.10.6. So that's very easy. You can simply type from platform import Python underscore version, and then you should press enter. And then you want to print this function. So you simply type Python underscore version. That's it. And now if you press enter, you can see here's the Python version that I'm using. It is 3.10.6, which you can verify that I have installed Python 3.10.6 correctly. And also you can do Python coding in the command window as well. So on your keyboard, press Windows and R key. So then here type CMD and press OK. And you can see a black window like this will be open. Here you can simply type Python and press enter. And you can see it says Python 3 10.6. So now we can start coding. So now suppose that I want to print 5 times 7. And if I press enter, you can see here is the result. So I can start coding here as well. If you remember, I've told you that we need to know the install location, and I've told you to copy the install location because we need it by the end of the video. And this is the time that we need that location. So go to the install location, and now we can see a file called python.exe. And remember that if you don't see these extensions, you should go to view and you should check file name extensions. If you don't check them, you can't see these extensions, but if you check it, you can see the extensions as well. So this python.exe is called interpreter of Python, which is a very important file, and you need this file for a lot of places. For example, if you want to install PyCharm, a very famous and very powerful IDE of Python programming language, then you need this interpreter. So remember that this is called the interpreter of Python, and this is a very, very important file. But let's start typing some stuff. So for example, I want to import a package called random. And as you can see, the auto completion of IDLE is very bad. For example, let's continue random.randint. And as you can see, the auto completion of IDLE is very bad. But now let's compare it to PyCharm, which is my favorite IDE. So now let's start those codings. So I simply type import random. So you can see the auto completion of PyCharm is very good. Now I want to use random.randint. As you can see, it suggests the function and the auto completion is very good. So I really suggest you to install an IDE like PyCharm, which is my favorite IDE. And it really helps you in writing your codes and also debugging your codes and a lot of stuff which you really need during the process of coding. So if you want to install PyCharm, which I really suggest you to do so, I recommend watching this video, which is on the screen now. It's a tutorial of how to install PyCharm step by step.